So today on my video blog, we're going to be unboxing the XFX Radeon HD 5750. Now, I grabbed this at the same time as the 5750, which I have on the table next to me, and you can see there's a quick size comparison here, but we're going to show with the 5750 later, so don't focus too much on that there, cameraman. Let's get this box open. You can see it arrived in a little bit better shape than our 5750 box with no obvious dents, so we won't be putting the packaging to the test today. From the front, it does not come with any games, which the other ones do. Both of the 5800 series XFX cards come with, what is that game, Dirt 2, and then the 5770 comes with Battleforge, which actually has a DirectX 11 patch available now. So, let's start getting this package open. It's a black box, just like the other 5000 series cards. We've got a quick installation guide right on the top, so that shows you the physical installation of the card, including plugging in the power connector. So this card does still require a 6-pin PCI Express connector. Here's your instructions to install the Catalyst drivers, which you should not be following because you should be downloading the latest drivers from the ATI website. Don't use this disc. It is drivers. Don't use it. Downloads. Okay, so then we have the XFX door hanger thing so that you can not be disturbed while you are gaming. And then we have the accessories. Wow, that is an empty accessory package. You have a power adapter. That was it. So, if you wanted to use this card with a VGA monitor, you will need to have your own adapter. You can't adapt the DVI one with the accessories in the box. Now that is a tiny card. Wow. This cooler actually kind of reminds me of the one that was on the 4770. So let's pull this out here and let's have a quick look. Okay, the first thing I really like about this card is you've got a huge fan on it. So this is actually a dual slot cooler. And you can see here, this part is just shroud, but you've got a big flower type heatsink here. And what that means is that this does not have to spin very fast because this is not a very powerful card in the sense that it doesn't consume a lot of power. So that means you're not gonna have a lot of excess heat and this thing should run really cool. So first thing, let's do the back connectors. You got the standard stuff for the 5800 series, two DVI, one HDMI, and one DisplayPort. You've got your standard crossfire connectors on the top. Then you've got at the back a 6-pin power connector. Then you can see that this is a standard PCI Express 16X card, so there is your connector along the bottom. On the back of the card itself, you can see that it doesn't have a shroud like the very high-end ones, but it does have a protective backplate, so that's going to hold on that cooler in the event that it should come off when you're shipping a system or something like that. You can see all the RAM chips on the back, and one thing I really wanted to do was a quick size comparison with the whole 5800 series family, so it's actually really easy to see which one the high-end ones are versus the ones that are the lower-end cards. So at the very top here, if I can get the cameraman to kind of come over top and pan all the way down, I'm going to point out which ones are which. So this is the 5870. This is the highest-end 5800 series card at the time of filming. This is the 5850. These two cards are based on basically the same platform. So there's a little bit of difference in clock speed, but these are the 5800s. Now, then we step down, we've got the 5770. This is more like a performance mid-range card that is about on par, maybe a little bit slower than the GTX 260. And then there is a slightly stepped-down version of the 5770, and that's the 5750, which we're looking at today. Thank you for checking out my video blog on the Radeon 5750.